So here we are in Premiere Pro, and we're going to learn how to export video from the program to share with the world. And we're going to do it in the simplest way possible. And lucky for you, it's actually really easy to do in Premiere Pro. So I've got a pretty typical little project lined up on the timeline here. It's a few video clips, some sound effects, and some music. And I actually put this all together based off just this one asset with the new beta version of the Envato Elements Premiere Pro plugin, which suggests different stock videos, music, and sound effects based on the assets that are in your timeline already. So if you do want to check it out, it's available for free right now on the Adobe Exchange. Just search Envato. Okay, so how do we export video from Premiere Pro? Well, the first thing that I like to do when I'm ready to export something, and let's say this project is completely finished, we want to share it with the world, I just click somewhere right at the end of my timeline and hit up on my keyboard, which takes me to the very end of the last clip. I then hit O on my keyboard, which sets an out point. And if you haven't already set an in point, it will default your in point to 0000 right at the start of your timeline. But let's say, for instance, your in point is randomly there, just drag your playhead like I'm doing now all the way back to 0000. Hit I on your keyboard, and now you'll have your in and your out point set. So the next thing you need to do is you need to go up to the top left here to the export page, or for the old hats among us, you can hit Command M, which takes you over to the export page. The old hats, all those who just like to use keyboard shortcuts. So over on the export page here from the left-hand side, you'll see that there are some presets. So if you know you're exporting for YouTube, Vimeo, Twitter, or X as it's known now, Facebook, etc., you can click one of those and it will default to the best settings for that platform. But if you're kind of just doing a generic media file, which might go up on a few different platforms, you can just do this media file preset here and then change a few different things as needed over on this settings side. So let's look at the settings side now. Pretty typical here, you've got file name, location, preset, and format. Put the file name in that you want, that's pretty self-explanatory, and then pop it where you want, also relatively self-explanatory. For presets, drop this down here, and you've got a couple of options here. Let's say we're going to do two exports. We're going to do one that we want to upload to the web, which will be a H.264 or MP4. And we're going to do a master, which is going to live somewhere on our hard drive, which will be the big high quality, high bitrate version of our finished project, which we can make copies of down the line if we need to. That would be a ProRes, and we're going to use Apple ProRes 422 in this case. So for the web ready version, the one we're going to upload right away, let's do high quality 1080p HD. I'm using 1080p because that's the timeline that I have set up. If you're working in 4K, pick 4K. Then for format, for the web-ready one, we do want H.264, which will give us an MP4 file. Then we'll drop down video here, and I like to just do match source. And if you've set your timelines up correctly, match source is the best one to do. You can change a few different things like frame size and frame rate in this section if you want, but if you do have your timeline set up accordingly, hit match source and it will kind of do it all for you. Then down here, you want to go into your audio, and for the most part, I always leave the audio settings unchecked. Double AC with 48,000 Hertz in stereo channel and a bitrate of 320 kbps works pretty well for everything. Now, we're not going to dive too much deeper into all of these other settings here. If you are exporting captions, you can turn those on here. I'm not going to go into detail in that because it is a little bit more in-depth, and you can find out how to put captions on in Premiere Pro and export with captions baked in and as a sidecar file over on the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel. So just go over there and search captions in Premiere Pro and you can find another one of my videos. All right, so that's what we've got there. And then you can see there's a little bit of a preview over here on the right-hand side. You can see down here in the range, it says source in out. So that's where we set our in and out points earlier. We set those in and out points at the start and the end of our clips. You can do entire source, the work area, other things like that as well. But I like to just do it by in and out points. I've done that for my entire editing career and it hasn't steered me wrong so far. So in and out points is the way to go, or my suggestion. You can see all of your other video file information down here. And then you can hit either send to media encoder or export. Now, if you are doing multiple exports and you then want to continue also working in Premiere Pro, you can send it to media encoder. But for ease of getting the video out of Premiere Pro, right now we're just going to hit the export button. There we go. It's now rendering and exported successfully, and it's gone to the destination where we wanted it. So that's our MP4 web ready version. Now I'm going to hit Command M again on my keyboard to go over to the export page, or again, you can just go up to the export section in the top left-hand corner. And now in our preset, we're going to go down to Apple ProRes 422, and then we're going to make sure that the format is on QuickTime, and that's going to give you a .mov file. Now for the video here, we're going to, again, select the codec, Apple ProRes 422. And again, I'm just going to do match source here. In audio, you'll get a few different settings compared to last time. So you're going to have uncompressed audio when you're exporting on ProRes. 48,000 hertz is fine, and sample size of 16-bit is fine as well. You can kick that up to 32 if you want, just a little bit more sound quality. But it really depends on the project you're working on. Honestly, you can leave the defaults here and you're going to be very happy. Again, we just go down here and we make sure our in and out points are set. We hit export or send to media encoder, depending on the way you want to do it. And there we go. That's exporting. And we've got our video successfully exported. So I'm going to bring up that Finder window now and we can have a look at the two different files. So here we can see the first one that we exported, which is our .mp4, our web ready copy, our H.264 version. And that is 25.3 megabytes. And then we've got our Apple ProRes 422, which is our .mov QuickTime file, and that is 151 megabytes. So you can see it's a much chunkier file there compared to the web ready one. So there we go. That's exporting video from Premiere Pro to share with the world. A couple of different ways and a couple of different file formats. I hope that helped.